Sometimes the best strikers just got blinkers on when it comes to getting themselves an opportunity to strike a goal, and Charlie Austin falls into that category. We've seen him smack them in from there more than once. Lots of swerve on the ball. Ball at the corner. Man got it out. Back in by Ward again. Direction by Craig Forsyth. It's a decent situation. He just hangs out the back post. I'm not sure Quinn Hill is aware, but he's there. It's a poor header, really. There's no reason why Craig Forsyth isn't heading that back into the dangerous area. His teammates to capitalise on. Could be a very useful man to bring on to make the difference. No doubt about it, Derby growing into it. This is Cranchard. He's been marked on the halfway line. And that's come off and away for a corner. There's no doubt about it, it was travelling. And it does just seem to be a bit more life, doesn't there? And a bit more energy about Derby County, which is why they've had such an amazing season. They break the play up there and they spring in numbers. Thorns on the outside, but Jamie Ward only got one thing in mind. That's to strike. It does strike Richard Dunn on the arm, but down by the side. Plenty forward here for the Rams. Ward will take. Really good delivery as well, and Green reacted superbly. Otherwise, we would have had the opener. Just the one, isn't it? It's an in-swinging free kick, but if it misses everything, it might go in, and Robert Green isn't fully concentrated. Team go goal down there. That is wonderful goalkeeping. So many goalkeepers go for the little flick and try and anticipate, and the ball ends up in the net, and you can see what they thought. Yes. Got it out one way and another this first half. Queen's Park Rangers control the opening stages of it, and Derby had their spell. This is more like Derby I've been used to seeing, I have to say. Much more controlled possession. Quinn Hill's done really well on his foul try already. He's leading the Queen's Park Rangers charge here. Armand Traore, the substitute. Seemed to get a bit of a nosebleed as he got into the penalty area. Quinn Hill does well and gives it to Armand Traore. And this is who Harry Redknapp would want on the ball. Possibly, arguably, the quickest player that Queen's Park Rangers have. So why is he not then running at Richard Keogh, knocking the ball past him, trying to make something happen? Must be doing much, much better than that. Wembley is crackling just now. Charlie Austin looks and anticipated well. This is Doyle. Now Traore. Now Austin just wide. That's the moment. What's the moment that he's been waiting for? And you put your house on him, wouldn't you? To hit the target. Please, watch him. He gets floored there by Buxton, but he gets himself into an area where he can score a goal and get the shot. It's pulled back to him. It's agonizingly close. He just doesn't get the kind of crisp contact or the direction that he's looking for. And that is the biggest chance of this playoff final so far. He talked in the build-up to the match. Patrick Davidson about unfinished business here at Wembley. He very nearly had a chance to finish it there. There's the change made. Doyle on, Zamora on. No surprise with that. That's two of the three substitutions used now by Harry Redknapp at Queen's Park Rangers. It's interesting. It just shows you how delicate the boys are, doesn't it? It's been Derby County that has more questions in this second half, albeit lots and lots of corners racking up and stacking up. At Rob Green's goal, but in a flash, game could have been turned on his head there. This is Ryan O'Neill. Oh,
championship.